Hi children, welcome back. So in the last video almost we have discussed the whole chapter of animal kingdom. So in this video we will start a new topic as leaf too has to say. It means what? Even the leaf also want to say something, or leaf has got an important role. So like this. So leaf, where the leaf will come? Leaf is a part of a plant, isn't it? So almost we all know the plant and the plant parts. There are several type of the plants on this earth. They are different in the size, the shape and the venation of their leaf, and the color of their fruit and the size of the fruit, taste of the fruit and uses of the fruit, isn't it? Even the fruit, flower, leaf, each plant has got the different important important for the in the different fields, isn't it? Then whenever I say the leaf will be there in the plant, and how the plant will look, just plant means already you have learned from your UKG class, even first time also you have learned. Plant means we can recall any flower plant or other plant or other show plants. Okay, plants means suddenly we will the picture will come in front of our eyes that a plant will be there of some certain height, and we have a stem and we have a leaf, we have a flower and we have a fruits, isn't it? And then if just you go just below the ground, we have a roots, okay? And this just after above the ground, the stem part will start. Then have you ever wondered, or have you ever thought, what are the works or what are the uses of this each part? Okay, as we know that the there will be a leaf, stem and the flower and the fruit and the seeds will be there, and just below the ground there will be a roots. Okay, if I start from the upper part of the plant, that is flower or a fruit, we know that fruit can be used to eat and it can be used to make a juices, it can be used to get a medicine, because these all are the fruits are giving us the nutrients. And even after eating that, inside the seeds will be there. Okay, even the some variety of seeds we use directly as a food in our diet or our in cooking of our food. You know that the mustard and the sunflower seeds, these all are going to give us the oils, and even the coconut, these all are going till coconut, these all are going to give us the oils. And some seeds will be there, even though we may not eat those seeds, but we are going to we are going to use it for the to grow the another one plant. This is how the use of the seeds. And then the fruit, and just now I told you we can eat directly or we can make the juice of that one, because those fruits are going to give us the lot of nutrients and the vitamins. Okay, those fruits are really much useful for our body to keep our body healthy. And then the leaf, as we have studied already in the previous classes, leaf has got the most important part in the plant. As the leaf is known as the food factory of the plant, because the leaf itself is going to produce the food and it is going to transfer the food from leaf to the all the parts of the plant. The leaf is very much important. And then after the leaf, the stem. We know that if the stem is very weak, if there is no stem, it's not at all possible to imagine the plant, because stem is a thing, or a stem is a part which is going to support the whole plant, which acts just like a backbone of the plant. Okay, so I hope you are getting my all the explanations, or I hope you are getting my all the points. Stem is going to help to support the plant, and it will help to hold the plant in a straight way, or strongly it is going to hold the plant against the weather and against the air. So like this, it is going to protect the plant and it will give a definite structure and the shape to the plant. And after the stem, the next is about roots. If there are no roots, can you imagine a plant without roots? So these all will help or act as a most important parts and the role in a plant's body. Okay, then the last under the ground, the part of the plant is roots. Okay, the roots are very much important or very much helpful to grow the plants or to leave the plants. If the plant is alive, then we have to tell that the roots are very nicely planted inside the soil, or they have fixed inside the soil. If the roots are not at all going to fix inside the soil, it's not possible for any plant to grow and be healthy. Okay. Then what is the help of the root? Just now I told you it is going to fix, it is going to hold, it is going to keep straight, it is going to take care of the whole plant. Roots are going to take care of whole plant. How it is they are going to take care of the plants? For example, from the soil there are the roots, they are going to suck the water, minerals and the other nutrients from the soil. They will suck and they are going to transfer from the roots, through the roots, to the other parts of the plant. So the plant can get all the nutrients, water from the soil. Okay, from the soil. Then it is going to be healthy, it is going to be grow. This is what the important role of each and every part of the plant. I hope you have learnt in the previous classes parts of the plant. Okay, but you might not learnt the what are the uses of the plant. These all are uses of the parts of the plants. I have not written any parts because already you know, and even you know the structure of the plant, you know the label, you may easily label all the parts. But in this chapter there is a most interesting and next information is that we are learning more about the roots here. So what is the last part of the plant here? That is roots. So we will learn about roots. Okay, so have you ever seen how the roots of a plant will be? Roots of the plants will be, okay, they will be of color, how, which color they will be, you know, the color of the roots, you know, and how they look, you know, and where they are located, you know. Then have you ever thought, is there any types, different types in the roots? Have you ever thought? Yes. Then how many types are there? Yes, there are two types are there in the roots. The types of the roots are two. One is tap root and second one is fibrous root. Tap root and second one is fibrous root. So now next we will discuss these two types of the roots very neatly. Then I will give you the simple definition for the tap root and the fibrous root in the next video. In this video we are going to end by this information, but before ending I will give you a simple homework. I will not tell you to draw a plant and label the parts, but I will tell you, you can write the role of the root and the stem and the leaf. Role means, can you understand what is the work or what is the uses of the roots and the stem and the leaf? Yeah, at least you have to write 3 points for each. Okay, I hope you will do the homework. In the next video, briefly we will discuss about these two types of the roots. Okay, bye-bye.